By far, the most successful meal frequency pattern is anywhere between... What's up, guys? Mike Dolce, four-time world MMA trainer of the year, number one best-selling author, and creator of the number one online weight loss platform at thedolcediet.com. Today, though, we're talking about meal frequency, and in this video, I'm going to teach you the exact time and ratio you should be planning your meals. This is one of the most hotly disputed topics for days and weeks and months and years and decades. Literally, since the dawn of man, you could see our ancient ancestors debating whether or not they should be following the OMAD one meal a day diet. They should have a modified intermittent fasting approach. If they should just follow the big three, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, or if they should break it up into a multi-feeding session six times or more per day. Well, let Uncle Mike break it down for you right now. Now, if we look at the data, if we look at all the peer-reviewed scientific studies, what will we find? We will find a shit show. We will find studies that literally support any idea that you can come up with. We can find studies that show, yep, one meal a day works, or two meal a days work, or three meals per day work, or four, or five, or six, or more. Now, anytime we see this, I always say, well, as compared to what? One meal a day works well. Well, as compared to what? One meal a day of perfect foods works well when compared to maybe the average American highly processed diet. Okay, that could work. But one meal a day does not work nearly as well as two meals a day. And two meals per day does not work nearly as well as four meals per day. So when we see these, the intermittent fasters and the dry fasters and the big three, we call them breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That's the traditional Aussie and Harriet style. But really, when we're talking about optimizing performance, we're looking at the world's most elite athletes, those who actually have to enhance their physicality, their aesthetics, their lean mass ratio, optimum substrate utilization for athletic performance and cognitive enhancement. We look towards those individuals, but also here at the Dolce Diet, we also look towards longevity. Those individuals who in general live the longest and have the lowest incidence of chronic disease. When we look at those groups, we will find that they eat more often throughout the day. They eat smaller meals, but more often. And this certainly does suit our principles, or I should say our principles were based upon this vision, this evidence. So when you look at the scientific studies, and everyone out there can point to any specific study, or more importantly, they can point to one soundbite in a study. This sound familiar, keto heads? You can pull one bullet point out of one study and then build your entire program out of that single bullet point. And that's what most of the fad diets do out there, like the keto, like the fasters, like maybe paleo did back when paleo was actually popular, and some of the other ones. So, likely for you and for me and for every other human on the planet, what I'm telling you right now is absolutely best. By far, the most successful meal frequency pattern is anywhere between 4 and 8 feeding sessions per day. When I say feeding sessions, I'm not talking about meals. And when I say meals, I'm not discounting snacks or shakes. When I say feeding sessions, I'm saying ingestion. Anytime you ingest calories, you ingest bulk food matter, that is considered a meal from our position. Anytime you are consuming nutrients, that is considered to be a meal. And if we are scheduling these out no less than 4 times per day, but typically closer to 6 times per day on average, we will see your body naturally and healthily improve in all aspects of athletic performance and also in longevity. Why? because now we are making our eating a part of our lifestyle. Our eating now becomes a part of our routine. We now have structure in our life. We now have the opportunity to ingest, digest, and absorb a higher amount of vital micronutrients, micro and phytonutrients. These are the most important aspects of nutrition anyway, but we're getting the most nutrient-dense foods into our body in a manner that does not overload our digestive system. Now, me being as sexy and strong and lean and rugged as I am, I need to consume a pretty large amount of food for me. Now, some individuals out there, the Fuad Abiyads of the world, might be eating 5,000 and 6,000 and 7,000 calories per day on their modified lean bulk weight class bodybuilding diets, and that's okay for them. But me at approximately 210 pounds at about 10% right now body fat, I need to take in about half of that, but I consume it in whole foods. We say raw food matter or bulk food matter, right? This is not processed foods. These are not chemically created, lab created calories. This is real food. When I'm consuming that much bulk food matter, I cannot ingest 3,000 calories, let's say, of healthful whole foods in one sitting. And number one, get it down. Number two, get it down in a manner that can be digested efficiently. I mean, just mechanical digestion, my jaw is going to wear out. Chemical digestion, my digestive system is going to be absolutely overwhelmed, and I am going to wind up passing much of this bulk food matter through without absorbing the vital micronutrients my cells desperately need. So, if I break that 3,000 calories, we'll use that as a round number. If I break those 3,000 calories down into 4 meals or 5 meals or 6 meals, now at 6 meals, I'm eating 500 calorie meals 6 times per day, evenly spaced 2 to 4 hours apart. That actually becomes a very beneficial method for me to get all the nutrition I need without overloading my digestive system. That also allows me to fit my schedule. I wake up, I get a little low intensity, steady state cardiovascular activity in, I eat a little breakfast, I get my day going, I have a little snack, I do a little more work, I have my lunch, I get my workout in, I have a post-workout, I take a shower, I go home, I have a nice dinner, and then I have a little bit of something later night before I go to bed, bang! 6 meals, 6 ingestions in, everything I need, it suits my life perfectly. Keeps me fed, keeps me fueled, keeps my digestive system operating optimally. If we look at the world's greatest athletes, we'll point to them first, we can see, I'm the four-time world MMA trainer of the year. I mean, just look around. I have performed more successful weight loss, body transformation changes for mixed martial artists than any other individual, any other team in the world, and I have done it with a 100% success rate. Nobody can make that claim, so you have to pay attention to what I'm saying, and this is what I'm telling you. Our athletes eat typically 4 to 8 times per day, usually 5 to 6 times per day in the off season, but closer to 8 times per day as we get ready for competition. We actually don't drop the calories, we increase the meal frequency. This actually helps our athletes get are more fueled, more satiated, keeps their energy operating or energy at a higher level during these higher stress periods. I'll do another video on that, on meal frequency and dealing with high stress. Different conversation, but it still does hold weight when I'm speaking here with you. Let's look at our friends across the stage in the bodybuilding world. Bodybuilders notoriously eat 6 meals per day. Look at bodybuilders. They hold more lean muscle tissue than any other athlete at lower levels of body fat than every other athlete. So you look at the bodies of mixed martial artists. They look like, you know, maybe physique athletes or classic physique. Then you look at the bodybuilders who are just huge and jacked. We look at gymnasts and wrestlers, to which we work with also. Look at those physiques, males and females alike. Look at swimmers. We work with swimmers. We work with all these amazing physique athletes, physical specimens, combat athletes, strength athletes, high-level performance athletes who need a high amount of relative lean muscle tissue at low levels of relative body fat. They are all eating multiple meals per day, typically closer to that 6 times per day. So all the intermittent fasters out there, all the one meal a day eaters, or the dry fasters, which is just absolutely ridiculous. Don't listen to those fools. They're stealing your money, quite honestly. Or those who are just eating the 3 times per day. Now, you can make the argument just based upon calorie ingestion versus expenditure. We can have that conversation too. But remember, I said in the beginning of this video, if we look at the data, I can prove anything. I can conduct a study to prove anything, right? I can prove anything. If I know what I want to prove, I can prove it. That's very easy. And I can get all the greatest, smartest PhDs, honorable PhDs into the room, and we can prove the same issue right and wrong with the same exact team of individuals, just altering a few concepts of the exact study being conducted, right? So that's easy stuff to do. Not to say that it's done often, but what I'm sharing with you is personal experience here. And that's the most important thing. What works? I'm telling you what works. This is what works. Multiple feeding times, evenly spread throughout the day. That creates structure. The body works best with structure. When we have structure, we remove variability. Variability is what will throw you off course. We have structure. We have rhythm. We have expectations. And bang, 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 bang. It's easier to get our meals in, to then start to calibrate our physique, to gain lean muscle tissue, to drop non-functional body mass, to maintain and balance, to recomposition. We can do all of this with this structure built in. But last, digestive efficiency is the most important aspect of this that most people overlook. When they're talking about calories in, calories out, they don't understand. They don't take hormones into consideration. They don't take stress levels into consideration. They also don't take digestive efficiency into consideration. Digestive efficiency is everything. It's not what you ingest, but what you absorb that matters. That's the most important thing. That's like saying you got 10 girls' numbers at the club last night, but zero called you back today. That's the absorption. How many did you actually get? How many did you close the deal with? How many of those micronutrients did you actually score with? Or did they just pass through you? That's what we're talking about here. Absorption is everything. And if we overwhelm our digestive system, we're not optimally absorbing. And if we're not eating enough of the vital micronutrients that are necessary, we are not optimizing our health, our wellness, our athletic outcomes, our long-term fitness and health objectives. So I hope this is helpful to you guys. I hope this explains this concept. I'm trying to make it super simple for everyone here. I'm not going to, be a Jeff Nippard and throw up a bunch of stuff. I'm not going to be a Greg Doucette and just start screaming craziness at you either. I'm really going to try and bring a very honest, evidence-based yet anecdotal approach. What actually works? 4-time World MMA Trainer of the Year, a 100% success ratio. There are very few coaches on the planet who can make the same claim that I actually can, and I've been heralded to do this. No one has more success in this industry than I do, and we all know combat sports, weight class-oriented combat sports are amongst the most difficult for any coach. And all the great coaches who are on YouTube, all the YouTubers, you guys all know me and you all understand, and you might disagree with what I'm saying, but you have to nod your head when Uncle Mike is talking because I'm telling the truth. So this is 100% from my experience, but everything every coach tells you is from their experience, and most coaches simply select bias-based selection. They select the information that suits their internal bias and they push it off onto you. I'm telling you very clearly, there's lots of studies out there that can really support any concept I want to throw at you. I'm telling you what I see works best for most of the people, most of the time, and I want it to work for you. So if you like this video, bang, bang, give me a thumbs up. Give me 250 thumbs up for this video. If you watch this video and don't give me a thumbs up, I will shed one tear. That could be thousands of tears. I'll get very dehydrated here if you don't give me a thumbs up. I appreciate you guys. Leave comments below. This was a user question. So if you guys have any specific questions, please let me know. I don't even think I shouted that out in the very beginning. Meal frequency, Ravi. So this came from our good friend Ravi on the Motivation Monday video. Adam, maybe you do see that and throw it up. So Ravi, thank you. Guys and gals, leave questions below. Leave comments below. Also, go back and look at our catalog of videos. videos. Click that little link up above. Click on videos. We got lots of great videos. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Check out some of the other amazing videos. I think you guys will like it. Until next time, boom.